Crafters may look like ordinary people, but they're really more like machines. They never stop working from dawn to dusk, they speak to each other in a programming language, and they do the same boring stuff over and over and over. Definitely not like us combat types. Here's a few things to remember if you decide to engage with one.
If you want to talk to a crafter, make sure you don't interrupt them while they're touching their balls. It's better to just sit back and watch while they're grinding them, pounding them, and even tasting them. Sometimes the balls turn red, but that's not your business. Just wait for the crafter to put the balls away so there's no distractions.
For crafters, there's only 0% or 100% with no gray area. And remember, only a smith deals in absolutes. Incidentally, they also don't like sand. On the flip side, crafters' distrust of numbers makes them highly superstitious. This means if you're standing nearby during one of their bad luck streaks, they'll consider you cursed, and you will be shunned, labeled an outcast, and banished from the sacred land. In the lonely wilds, you'll be forced to become a crafter yourself, and that is how new crafters are born. Crafters are a lot like a beast tribe. If you want them to do something, you've got to offer a mountain of crystals. And they worship a divine entity. Who is this god among crafters?
Well, they are godbird, after a fashion, yes. The greatest and most powerful of crafters. If a crafter asks how you are doing, avoid saying good or excellent. This will make the crafter touch you, somehow making your condition worse. Some crafters thrive in packs, near market boards, in cities. These are social creatures, likely safe to approach. But others may hide themselves in caves, nooks, or under bridges. Do not approach a lone crafter. Being far from a market board or retainer bell, they'll see you as a walking shipment of materials. Blood. Fur. Meat. So don't give them a chance to weave goodbye. Go back to town before they drive a nail in your coffin. Or cook your goose, or make you walk the plank. I'm saying there could be trouble brewing. And if something happens, they'll be the only one who saw it. I hope this guide will help you better communicate with your crafter friends, but be advised that no matter what you say, they're very good at tuning out noise and focusing on their inner quiet. They might seem like they're ignoring you, but to a trained eye, they're taking time to reflect on what you said. If you like this video, please consider supporting the channel on Patreon or on Twitch. You can support the channel for free by hitting that subscribe button or by sharing this video with your fellow Warriors of Light. Thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!